We try to show you very interesting codes about the Bible code. Okay, this is for people who are interested to really to know about more about the Bible code, because no looking into the table properly, not hearing what it is, repeating the time. Because this is doctrine, this is Torah. Yeah, I mean, you have to learn it properly. There are quite few tables which correspond to each other. So, very important, really, this one also, all ones, but all of them really are very significant and important. Yeah.
Bible code, Torah code are true when you see clearly that what is happening with the code is far away from being coincidence. And one of the examples is what you see now. There is another 1820, the 3,000-year-old secret. About this number, lot of material in www.1820.co.il. Look into it, because it is something which is unbelievable. So many explanations about this number and how it fits in the Torah. 1820 time, both them in the Torah. 1820 Gematria of Bereshit, Genesis, 1820 verses, the beginning of the new month. So, and many, many others. So this is called a secret number, and on this number many things came out, and what you are going to see now, tables which have to do with redemption, with Messiah, with Israel, based on this number, which really far away from being coincidence. So let us still start, here is in English, in order that you will understand what you see is the following. You see here, Messiah, parallel, which is very significant, we said. Again, Messiah skip. Then you have parallel, redemption, which is redemption, parallel, very significant. You have this here, 779. You have the verse here, Geulah, redemption, and redemption twice and twice. Then you have condition. That you will have Messiah, that you will have redemption is repentance coming here, and you shall observe my Shabbos, this is what God says. Keeping the Sabbath, keeping purity of life, this is. Now, so what you see here, very significant table, and as we see it now in Hebrew, you will see that really all this table based on other 1820. So this is in Hebrew, this table, basically, which also Messiah, keep my Sabbath, redemption, repentance, 5779. So what really you have here? As you see on top, you have 9-10. What is 9-10? 9-10 is half of 80-20. Now the question why? Because you see here the word 5779. Letter after letter, it comes. In 1820, but what happens with Messiah? You can see there is a line in between. It means that basically, from this letter, Messiah, Mem Kedushin is 1820, but in order that you will see other words in the same table, so the line was cut into two, so there is line in between. So because it is line in between, it is really 9-10. But basically, the distance between letter to letter, Messiah and so on, is 18-20. So, Messiah 18-20 three times, you have Messiah. Parallel, very significant, can be coincidence. And then you have the third one, so we said many times that Abba Kessin said there is three Messiahs. Messiah, the son of Joseph, son of Jesse, and Messiah helps Israel, called Cyrus at that time, and Trump is this time. So, as we said, amazingly, you have the basis of 1820, you have coming of these verse. Now, let us see more 1820. Now, these are really straight. because here you see 1820, and you have here 577, and this year open for Mashiach. Amazing. That's mystical. Messiah 577. We should be very happy, but what we just do again is about Teshuvah. The Shin is the Shin of Israel. Teshuvah comes here, and again the condition which we saw in many other places, we see. Shamu b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat, let Israel keep the Shabbat, keep the Sabbath, do the Sabbath. For all generations, Brit Olam, it is eternal covenant between me and you, God said, between the children of Israel. Or it is a sign forever, eternal sign. What we see, you have Lapid today, you have Lieberman, you have others. Leftists who are doing everything against it. Desecrating the Shabbat, desecrating the holiness of family life, and so on. How can you have Messiah when the Torah says clearly? But as we said many times, that Maimonides, the Rambam said, according to the Talmud, that Israel will be redeemed only by repentance. Repentance in the Shabbat is everything. And if they will not, God promised they will do. So who knows? It can be because of a threat of war. Like in the 60th war, we don't know. But clearly, come here, 1820 is a secret number, 5779, Messiah, Tshuva, keeping the Shabbat. Exactly like the previous ones, right? Also, you have Shabbat here, you have repentance. Exactly. Now let us see another one. And you have another one here, something very interesting. It's a sentence. Yom Shabbat Tishmeru, Tishmor, speaking to the Jewish people, is it the word Israel, the children of Israel, yeah? Therefore, keep the Sabbath. Yeah, it's a sign for the Jewish people, Israel. So, when Israel comes here, and let us see what more is about. Here, by the way, is the word Shuvu, return. I'm going to do it, Shuvu, return. And exactly. Is written the word Yom Shabbat Ishmo, very interesting, such a long sentence, and exactly 1820, coincidence. It's on the Torah, and the one since 1820, Sheshet Yamim Tasem Lachar, this is the verse of the Torah. In Exodus, 6 days, you should do work, but on the seventh day, Shabbat Shabbaton, Kodesh, Sabbath Shabbaton is holy. Then if you will keep the Sabbath, which is equal to Kol Mitzvot Hashem, everybody says that keeping the Sabbath is like keeping the Old Torah, which is the basis of faith of God. And again, parallel Messiah, then you will have Messiah. Peace with the idea before, also that keeping the Sabbath is brings Messiah. Another one, this is another one, really, it's not so clear, but this is what we need to about. But here also, here you have Israel. Israel, yeah, every 1820, you see, 1820, Israel, you know, something you can find easily. So, is it in Israel here, as Messiah, definitely, and also, as the other places, Bayom HaShvihi, Sabbath, Kodesh, Holy, then comes here, very interesting idea, which is the verse. We mentioned very interesting. There's a verse we're speaking about redemption. See, Galenu, Redimas, Redimas. And then it's written, Dodo, Bendodo, as a cousin or the uncle, we read it. But in Hebrew, Dodo should be the little Vav. Now it is written without Dalet, Dalet, Vav, exactly like David. So our Rebbe tells us that really, uncle and cousin represent David. And son of David, the son of Jesse, but amazing, and this is exactly the verse we said, Yikalenu, redeem us, they're all truly redeem us, but only in condition the Torah Shmur, that you should keep the Torah. And it is the seventh day Shabbos you should keep. So altogether, very interesting table, again, 1820, Israel in this number, it's a completely another story. The others were Messiah, every 1820. 5, 7, 7, 9, but here, another effect, this is much clearer. You can see here clearly Israel. This case you have Israel with this here, 5, 7, 7, 9, and small sheep of repentance. Maybe that message to Israel. If you repent and do repentance, then you will have redemption. Then we have Messiah. You have Messiah twice. Messiah Hashem, Messiah Hashem, Messiah God. Son of Joseph, and son of David. Amazing. Again, 1820 Israel. So it can be coincidence when you have Israel, you have 6 years, and you have first Messiah, and small skip of Tshuva and redemption. Definitely anybody who have common sense. But unfortunately, as I see when people speak, react to tables, you know, without knowing what is a table, immediately they don't like. They don't like. It's funny, you know, people today, you know, to call them. It's silly or blocked. They don't look at all what a table calls. He made comments without nothing. It's a fine thing. How can people live about it? It's a fine thing when people live without thinking. So let us hope that people will think properly and will realize that what we see here, it is a clear proof to the Bible, to the Torah, because to have this also in Moby Dick, it's really nonsense. So, important significant table, as we say, about this number 1820. So it's very, very much recommended that you will go into this site, www.1820.co.il, you will see wonders, simple wonders that is unbelievable. Rabbi, more than 100 years ago, said this. So important, significant table, watch each one properly, and we can realize that it's far away from being coincidence. And all this teaches you, teaches Israel, you know, that Satan is very strong, especially before the time of Messiah. This is really the opposition now in Israel to religion, you know, Lieberman suddenly comes with such incitement, you know, it's frightening, it's something which never ever such as it. This is a Satan. The Satan is worried that Jews will do Tshuva and Messiah will come. They will need to keep the Torah. It's difficult to keep the Torah. The Shabbat. They want to go out on Shabbat to see them and enjoy themselves. But the time will come, no doubt about it. The Torah says the Jews will do Tshuva, will repent. Who knows if it's not because of what is now developing with Iran. So it's better to do Tshuva before, because after all, the great preaching is the question if the repentance will accept it, because one should do Tshuva when it is still free will. So, interesting table, important table, and again, recommended to look into the site of 1820. And you will see one verse. So,